All right, so now in this video, we are going to set up the pages on our website that are going to be for LifterLMS. Now, what I'm talking about is the specific page that's going to work as the shopping cart and the checkout process is going to occur on. And then we need to set up a members dashboard page. And then we need to set up a page that we're going to use to list all of our available courses. And then we're going to set up an optional page to list all of our available memberships. So it's actually very easy to do. So I need you to go into your download package right here, and you've got these folders, of course, but this one right here says LifterLMS shortcodes. And when you double click on that, you're going to have a text file that says LifterLMS shortcodes. And I need you to open that for this video. And so here is that text file opened up. Now, the way we do this is with something called a shortcode. Now, right here is what one of these shortcodes look like. I have them all listed out here. And essentially, what a shortcode is in WordPress is a way for you to take a plugin like our learning management system and an aspect of it and place it exactly where you want on a page by page or different areas of your website to place it in a specific location. So for instance, we have a shortcode here for the members dashboard, and we just need to drop that on the page we're designing that's going to be our members dashboard. And then we have another one right here for our payment page where we're going to have our checkout. So you can create any page, name it whatever you want, style it whatever you want. And as long as this shortcode's there, that is going to facilitate the checkout when someone orders one of your courses. And then we have this here for our course index page. That's going to be the page that's going to list all of our available courses. And right here we have the same thing, and it is for the members index page if you're going to sell memberships or course bundles. And there's our shortcodes. Now, there are more than these shortcodes available, and some of the shortcodes have options. So right here is the link to the document on shortcodes for this plugin, and you'll get to see all the shortcodes and all the options. So for instance, here is the shortcode to list our courses, and you can see they have these things called operators in it. So one here says order by, and I have it ordered by date. So that is the order that the courses are going to appear. And then right here's an option, how many of those courses to show on that page, on a single page. So it's set to 6. You can reduce this to 3 if you wanted, or you can make it higher. It's completely up to you. On my website, I have it show 9 courses at a time. So all we need to do in this video is put these shortcodes where they need to go, and it's going to just automatically work. Now, I obviously haven't gone through the learning management system yet. That's going to be after this video. And so I just wanted to do this first because we're still building out the front end look of the website. So I'm going to move this off to the side, and let's start with our member dashboard. So I'm going to go into pages, and we have the members dashboard right here. I'm going to go ahead and click on that, and I already set this up in the prior video. I made a template. I chose the template full width, and then I clicked on Elementor. So let's go in there and drop this shortcode. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put that shortcode in the clipboard of my computer. Just, you know, copy it, and then I'm going to paste it in here. So we have this header I designed, and you know, we can put whatever we want for the title and whatever you want right here for the subheadline, or you can remove it. It's all up to you. What we need to do is add a new section. So I'm going to click add new section. It's just going to be one column like this, and then there is an element here called shortcode. So you can just start typing it in right here. Here it is, shortcode. So I'm going to drag and drop shortcode right there. And then right here, we're going to paste that shortcode. So I'm just going to paste it in like that and then click on apply. And you can see it's already added our members dashboard information right there. And you can see I'm logged in, so it's obviously showing me that. And this is not actually how it looks by default. It's that custom CSS we added in the customizer video that makes it look this beautiful with these tabs up here. I mean, your students are going to be so impressed by the professionalism of your website. Okay, and if we like the way it looks, we can just go ahead and save it. You might want to add a little bit of margin to the top and the bottom to kind of push it down a little from here, but that's completely up to you. If you did want to do that, you would just go ahead and click on Section and then go to Advanced, and then you can add some margin right here to the top and bottom. Hey, let's just go ahead and maybe add, I don't know, like 50. Let's go to 50 just like that. And so that's going to add it to the top and the bottom. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Save, and then I'm going to click on the X. But instead of going to the dashboard like I've done in the past, I'm going to click on View Page, and it just opens it up in a new tab. And this is actually very nice. I really like the way this came out. And you can see there's all these tabs right here for your students to see their courses and to edit their account details, redeem a voucher. I'll go over that, and I'll see their order history. And you can just see how professional this is already. So I'm actually seeing a problem right here. I put some negative margin on this header, and it looks like when we actually view the page that it's starting to cover the area where we're going to put our logo. You see how it's cutting it off? So I need to actually go in and change that. So I'm going to go back because Elementor's still in there, and I'm going to go ahead and click on Section for this header area right here. I'm going to click on Advanced. I made it that minus 40. So let's actually change that to minus 20 like this. I'm going to click on Save. And then let's take a look at it right here. I'm just going to do a refresh, and that should push it down some. So actually, it's up to you how you want to do that. If you want to stick with what I was doing with the negative margin to pull it up, or whatever you want to do there. This is actually how it looks with nothing. Let's just go to nothing, click on Save. And I'm going to go back to the dashboard. I'm going to do a refresh. And so if this is fine with you, you can do that. Maybe if you did, maybe reduce some of the spacing here or there. But whenever you use negative margin, you have to be careful. And it looks like I lifted it up over this logo area, which is not a good thing. But using lots of space on your website is not a bad thing either. So I like how this looks without it, actually. But I do like the 50 I put here and the 50 I put there. So anyways, our members dashboard is done. So I'm going to go ahead and close that page, and right here I'm going to click on the X. I'm going to go back to the dashboard. Now the next page we're going to do is our checkout page. So let me go ahead and copy the payment page short code. All right, and now I'm going to click on all pages, and I'm going to go to that page. It's right here where it says purchase. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And I haven't touched this page before, but you can see it actually already has the checkout short code right there. So let's choose template. I'm going to go full width like that. I'm going to click on update. And then I'm going to click on Edit with Elementor. All right, so what happens when you have a page that had some text content and then you convert it into an Elementor page? It kind of pulls that content in to a section, as you can see right here, and it tossed it in the text editor. But I'm going to go ahead and delete that out because I don't want that at all. So I'm going to click on Section. I'm going to go to Delete. And I've got my blank page. I'm going to click on Add Template, and then I'm going to go to My Templates, and I'm going to use my page assets like this. I'll go ahead and insert that. Now, let's see if that has that negative margin at the top. It might, because I might have saved it with that. So it did, so I'm just going to take it out. And there we go. I don't want a button on this page, so I'm going to go ahead and delete out that button. And let's put that short code in. So I'm going to go to Add New Section, a single column like this. Now, you can actually do some really cool stuff with LifterLMS on the checkout page. You see those fancy schmancy checkout services now. There's one called Sam Cart, and it's like $1,200 a year. And there's another one called Thrive Cart, and that's like $600. And they have all these fancy designs on the checkout page to increase conversion, when essentially all it is a two column layout, and on the right there's information like a testimonial to reinforce trust and their purchase. There's maybe a safety seal or some kind of a trust seal, maybe a guarantee, and you have all that kind of in like a sidebar looking area on the right, and then you have the checkout information on the left. Well, you can actually totally duplicate those layouts. Maybe at a later video in this series I'll add a video on how to kind of increase the conversions by adding these stylish proven elements to the checkout page. But right now we're just gonna go with it the way that it is. So, all right, so I did that. Now I need to go ahead, I'll hit the dial pad and I need to do the short code again. Okay, here's my short code element, drag and drop it. I'm gonna paste it in. Okay, it's already pasted in there. And now I need to click on the apply button just like that. And I wanna add that same spacing I did on the members dashboard to the section where I added 50 to the top and bottom. So I'm gonna go into that section, advanced, and let's just increase this 250 so everything's not so scrunched together. So there we go, I've got my 50, and that is it for my checkout page. Obviously, we actually want to put something right here. I seem to have lost my headline font. I wonder if that's just in the editor. So I'm going to go ahead and roll with it real quick. And let's put a title. Okay, and then I'm going to put a subheadline in there. Okay, I just said customer checkout and you're making a great decision. I'm going to go ahead and click on save. And then I'm going to click on this X. And then I'm going to click on view page. And there it is. So that's weird that just momentarily. I wonder if I hit a hard refresh if that will start showing the right font. Actually, let's just go ahead and play it risky and do a hard refresh. Okay, there it is. I don't know why that happened, but that's okay. So right here is the checkout page and we just wrote customer checkout. You're making a great decision right there. And right here, we don't see any of the elements of the checkout because we haven't added a course to the checkout process, and that's okay for now. So I'm gonna go back here and let's move on to the next page. So I'm gonna click on X, I'm gonna go to the dashboard, just like this, and then I'm gonna click on all pages. Now the next one we're gonna do is the course index page, like this. Let me put this into my clipboard. Okay, now before we go any further, right here we see the page that LifterLMS created called Course Catalog, and it created this called Membership Catalog. Now the only thing I don't like about using these pages is if you use them and choose to not use the short code way, LifterLMS kind of overrides everything you do on here and it doesn't let you style it the way that you want. So that's why I created my own course page and my own membership page. Actually wanted to change that to courses. And then what I'm going to do is use the short code on this page and on this page, and then I'm going to delete this one and I'm going to delete that one. Whenever LifterLMS links itself up to that page, you can't control the style of it. And I want a stylish page on every aspect of my website. So I'm going to go to course right here and I'm going to fix the name because I should have earlier. Okay, so now that that name is fixed, I already in a prior video added the full width template. So I'm just going to go ahead and update that. And now I'm going to go into Elementor. And I think I did the page header on here. I just need to go ahead and add my short code and actually change what I want there for my courses. So I'm going to click on add new section, single section, and I'm going to go and do the short code again. All right, there it is. Drag and drop it into the section. Paste it here and then go ahead and click apply. Now right now it's only showing the one course and this is the default course. As we create courses, they're going to start lining up here, three in a row, and that's how it's going to be. So now I want to change the title right here. So let's put something in. Let's get ready to learn. And then let's put something here for the subheadline. There we go. I'll stick with you every step of the way. I'm going to do a save. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on the X. And I want to view the page. And we're going to see there is our headline. Here is our subheadline. And then right here is our course right there. And we're going to start seeing them. It looks like I didn't put that margin here. I actually want to do that. So let me just go back. And that was in the section advanced. And I think I went with 50, so it's going to push it down and it's going to give it some margin on the bottom as well. So let me click on save and let me go here and now I'll do a refresh and you can see now I have some better spacing right there. So there you have it. That was actually pretty easy. Oops, it looks like one more thing. I need to remove that margin here at the top. All these little things. So I'm going to go to section, I'm going to go to advanced, and I'm going to go ahead and delete that out like that, and then we are back to normal. All right, so let me just double check with the refresh, and there we go. That's our course index page right here when someone clicks on courses. Last thing now is this membership page, and this is optional if you're going to have memberships. Let me get out of Elementor here. If you're going to have memberships, and the purpose of memberships I'll explain in more depth later, but you can bundle courses together, and you can also protect other bits of content on your site like blog posts or other pages. So if you wanted a download page or some kind of a live page where you embed some kind of live video feed, you can do that. So I'm going to go to all pages. I'm going to go ahead and click on memberships. I'm going to change my template to that full width template, click on update. And now I'm going to click on edit with Elementor. I'm going to go to add template. I'm going to go to my templates, page assets, insert, and I'm going to add a new section, single, and I'm going to put my short code just like this. I've got my short code in there and I need to paste it in. Let me first copy it. Okay, there it is. Paste, apply. We don't actually have any memberships, so that's why it's going to show this page. We don't have anything there. So let me go ahead and remove the button. Let me drop in a quick page title. Let me add a subheadline. I know I'm choosing the most corny titles and subheadlines. Okay, let me see the spacing at the top there. So I'm going to click on section, advance, and there's that 40 again. Let me just blow that out. Oops, and I got to add my margin here. So I'm going to click on section there, and let me just bump that up to 50 so it's consistent with everything we've done on the other pages. And I'm going to do a save. I'm going to click on the X right here, and then let's go ahead and view that page. So there we go. And this will be where your memberships show, and I haven't explained that to you yet. So essentially, we have now filled out all of these. So if I click on Home, it's going to show us our home page. If I click on Members Dashboard, it's going to show me the Members Dashboard. Now, if I was not logged in right now, it would show the login form right here. I love that. I'm going to go ahead and click on Courses. We have our one course. I'm going to click on Memberships. We don't have any of those. I'm going to click on Purchase. We don't have anything in the cart. But hey, let's see what happens here. I don't know how they configure this course. So let's see when I click in it. This is just the default one that they give you so that you can learn from. So when I click on it, let's see what happens when I click on Enroll. It actually just might enroll me, which is probably not what I want. So let's see. Oh, good. It didn't enroll me. And this is what I wanted. It took me to the checkout page. So you see, now I'm on the purchase page. And this is what the purchase page looks like right here. Now, this is having everything in one column. So this is actually perfect if you wanted to, in Elementor, make this a two column layout, but the left column make it take up more space and put your trust symbols and all kinds of cool things. I'll have to make a video on that. But this is what your checkout looks like, and I'm going to modify the way we configure this. Right now, it's asking for addresses and information like that, which I don't like to ask people personally because I don't need it. I'm going to show you how to tweak that. But the point was, the checkout page is already working. Whew, this is some exciting stuff right here. And I know that you should be excited at how far you've made it and how close you are to this finish line. So like I said earlier, in that text file, you can see all of the LifterLMS short codes. And if you want to see all of them, you can just go to this link right here and you can see them on LifterLMS's website. And you can see all the different parameters for ordering your courses and things like that. So that is all of our page design stuff and pretty much everything we're going to use Elementor for. Now we're going to get to go in and actually learn how to use this stinking learning management system.